UN Chief Antonio Guterres calls for an end to what he calls a toxic cover-up by companies. A sweeping report released Tuesday by UN experts set out a number of strict recommendations for business, banks, and governments making net zero pledges to ensure that their promises amount to meaningful action instead of false assurances. Guterres appointed the group at last year's climate summit to draw principles aimed at clarifying the confusion around the growing numbers of net zero claims. The experts found that there's been little transparency or uniform standards when it comes to the pledges, resulting in a boom in the number of hard-to-verify claims. Among their recommendations is for government to put in place binding regulations.
Commitments to net zero are worth zero without the plans, policies, and actions to back it up. Our world cannot afford any more greenwashing, fake movers, or late movers. The recommendations in today's report are clear. End our reliance on fossil fuels. Avoid the lock-in of new fossil fuel infrastructure. Invest massively in renewables. Renewables are a win-win-win solution for climate action, guaranteeing energy security, providing affordable access to electricity, and generating new jobs.
The U.S. will stick to its efforts to develop a greener economy, even if the Republicans win the midterm elections. That assurance coming from Biden's climate envoy, John Kerry, as he sought to reassure the UN COP27 summit on Washington's energy transition plans.
Our hope is obviously that the United States will be able to have a Congress that puts the budget up. But even if we don't, folks, President Biden is more determined than ever to continue what we're doing. And most of what we're doing cannot be changed by anybody else who comes along, because much of it has to do with working with the private sector, with the marketplace. And the marketplace has made its decision to do what we need to do to respond to the climate crisis.
The UN climate summit in Egypt has been dominated by calls for wealthier nations to step up their commitments to cut greenhouse gases and fulfill pledges of financial assistance to poorer nations. Developing countries devastated by natural disasters have argued for a windfall tax on the profits of oil companies and demanded that rich polluters compensate them for the damage caused by their emissions.
Committed to making certain that we, the developed countries, we, the largest economy in the world, the second largest emitter, have a special responsibility to less developed nations, to the third world, to the South, and we need to do and will do what is necessary to help make sure that this is a just transition. That is imperative for everybody.
The proposed 5.3 trillion peso Philippine national budget for next year inches closer to approval. Senators on Tuesday endorsed the 2023 General Appropriations Bill to the plenary, setting the stage for debates to begin Wednesday. In his sponsorship speech, Senator Sunny Angara said the proposed spending bill would address pressing problems hounding the country. He also rejected allegations some items in the budget were recycled from the previous administration.
The president has made it clear in his message to us that every peso that he seeks to spend in 2023 is aligned with his administration's thrust. And what are these? To boost growth, to cut poverty, to trim the deficit, to pare down debt, and to catapult us to the league of upper middle income nations. Our economy remains debilitated by the effects of long COVID. Although we have installed springboards for recovery amidst the rubble, the takeoff is not yet in the desired velocity that will propel us past the damages it has caused. Then there is the war in Ukraine, Mr. President, which is seven time zones away from us, but did not spare us from the fallout of fuel, food, and fertilizer crises it has unleashed. Kaya maling isipin ang budget ay simpleng spreadsheet o listahan ng mga numero lamang.
Both houses of Congress are aiming to get the 2023 national budget signed into law by President Marcos before Christmas.